Hello there! The other night I went to bed racking my brain for a video idea, and the next morning, for some reason, I woke up thinking about swashbuckling movies, and I said, "Hey, that'll work." I have always enjoyed a good swashbuckler, and I've seen quite a few, so I thought today it would be fun to count off my three favorite classic swashbuckler films. By classic, I mean old, so unfortunately that leaves out the first Pirates of the Caribbean, The Princess Bride, and the 1982 version of The Scarlet Pimpernel, even though those are all excellent swashbucklers that I thoroughly enjoy. I should also explain, for anyone who is not familiar with the term, that the swashbuckler subgenre of film and literature is an action and adventure story set in some historical period. There's usually a handsome, somewhat cocky, but still likable hero pitted against an evil villain, and they inevitably end up fighting each other with swords. There's usually a pretty but spirited damsel in distress, and all kinds of fun things like disguises and daring escapades. Now for my three favorites, which all came out in the same period, the same 4-year span, which is just a coincidence. Number one is The Mark of Zorro from 1940, the familiar story of the Spanish nobleman who assumes the masked identity of Zorro, fighting to save California from dictatorship while pretending to be a foolish fop in society so that no one will suspect him. This movie is actually a remake of the 1920 silent film of the same name with Douglas Fairbanks. Tyrone Power doesn't quite reach Fairbanks's legendary level of acrobatic agility, but I think he's great all on his own. He's an energetic fighter, he's got charisma, his foppish affectations are hilarious, and, well, he's Tyrone Power, so he's very attractive. Starring opposite Power is Linda Darnell, who looks gorgeous in her old Spanish costumes and has a lot of fun chemistry with Power. Her character finds his foppish persona repulsive, but then there's a moment where they're dancing, and he lets his disguise slip, and she catches just a glimpse of his real character, and you see the first spark ignite between them. It's followed later by a fun scene where she's in a chapel praying, and he enters disguised as a friar, and they have some interesting dialogue as she tries to get a peek at his face. Zorro's chief antagonist is Captain Esteban, played by Basil Rathbone. Rathbone has become most famous for playing Sherlock Holmes. It's not as commonly known that he was an expert swordsman. He fenced in many a movie, and because he was almost always playing the villain, he spent most of his time losing, but not before putting in an amazing performance. A good sword fight is a pleasure to see. Rathbone is considered one of the best in the business, and according to him, Power was one of his most worthy opponents. So pit these two against each other, and you have one of the best sword fights ever filmed. When the fight starts, the music cuts out, and there's nothing but the rapid clashing of blades. So good. Number two is 1937's The Prisoner of Zenda. I've spoken about this movie once before at some length in my five favorite Ronald Colman movies video. Colman, who is one of my favorite actors, has been Turner Classic Movies Star of the Month this month, and I've been having a grand time spending my Thursday nights with him. So, just in case you'd like to know, The Prisoner of Zenda will be airing next Thursday night after A Tale of Two Cities. The Prisoner of Zenda is a movie that feels a little like a fairy tale, in which the King of Ruritania is drugged and kidnapped the night before his coronation. Two of the king's right-hand men persuade the king's lookalike, an Englishman passing through the country on vacation, to stand in for him on coronation day in order to prevent the king's evil half-brother from seizing the throne. From there, all kinds of complications ensue. The cast is great. Besides Colman, who I love in any movie, there's Madeline Carroll, looking radiant as Princess Flavia, David Niven in one of his early roles, I believe this was his big break, key parts for C. Aubrey Smith and Mary Astor, Raymond Massey as the jealous half-brother to the king, a sinister, monocled mastermind, using Douglas Fairbanks Jr. as his bloodthirsty henchman. Fairbanks Jr. is having so much fun here. It's like there's a friendly contest going on between Colman, Fairbanks, and Niven to steal the show. The story is a lot of fun, but more than that, I love the romance, the humor, the conflict. It doesn't have quite the best sword fight in history, since fencing wasn't Coleman's forte, but the verbal jabs between Coleman and Fairbanks make up for that, and the whole thing is just a fun, romantic adventure, a great escapist movie. Number 3, I absolutely could not get away with making a video about swashbucklers without including an Errol Flynn film, because he was like the king of swashbucklers. So my third selection is The Adventures of Robin Hood from 1938. You know the Robin Hood story. He and his band of merry men steal from the rich and give to the poor. He woos Maid Marian and mocks Prince John, etc. I must confess that Robin Hood lore is not something I've ever been especially drawn to, but this movie is a must-see. Unlike my other two picks, this movie's in color. And not just any color, but Technicolor! The vibrancy of the images is delightful, making this easily one of the best color films of the 1930s. Errol Flynn's leading lady in this, as she was on so many other occasions, is Olivia de Havilland. It amazes me how she manages to still look so stunning in some of these outfits. Of the 8 movies Flynn and de Havilland starred in together, I've seen 5. Their on-screen chemistry has been well noted, and I think this movie has a couple of their best scenes together. I would argue that that balcony scene is more romantic than the one in Romeo and Juliet. This is another movie that has a large supporting cast. Patrick Knowles, Alan Hale, Una O'Connor, Eugene Pallett, who plays a friar in both this and The Mark of Zorro. And, as it should, being a Robin Hood film, it boasts 2 great baddies. Claude Rains, another of my favorites, is deliciously wicked as Prince John. And again, we have Basil Rathbone in a somewhat similar role as in The Mark of Zorro, here playing Sir Guy, doing the despot's dirty work and sporting a healthy disdain for the protagonist that quickly turns into hatred. Flynn's sword fight with Rathbone makes for a noteworthy climax, with the way the two of them move around the huge castle set, interacting with the scenery and casting their shadows on the walls, all accompanied by Eric Wolfgang Korngold's lively music. It's a prime example of the excitement and energy that characterizes every classic swashbuckler film. So those are my top 3. I'd love to know what you think, what your favorites are, if you have any. So leave a comment and let me know if you like. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching! Bye!